Hello, Vital Sign. Today we're going to talk about the Hajós construction. The Hajós construction is defined as follows. Let G and H be undirected graphs, and VW an edge in G, and XY an edge in H. Now identify vertices V and X, that is, merge them into a single vertex, Z. Next, delete the original chosen edges, ZW and ZY. Finally, add a new edge between vertices W and Y. That's all there is to it. Let's work through a few more examples to get the hang of this operation. Suppose we have two complete graphs on four vertices. What we must do is choose two edges for our Hajós construction. Let's choose AB and 1, 2. Merge vertices A and 1 into a single vertex. Now delete the edges from Z to B and from Z to 2. Finally, draw an edge from vertex B to vertex 2. This is one result of applying the Hajós construction to these two graphs. It just so happens that this graph is known as the Moser spindle and provided us with a long-standing lower bound of 4 for the chromatic number of the plane, which is still an open problem in graph theory. Look up the Hadwiger-Nelson problem if you want to learn more about it. It's a very cool problem. Moving on, let's tackle another example, this time with graphs that are not identical. Suppose these are our two graphs. Again, we must choose two edges to apply the Hajós construction. Let's pick CB and 1, 2. First, identify vertices C and 1. Next, delete the edges from our merged vertex to vertices B and 2. Finally, draw an edge between vertex B and vertex 2. This is the result. Note that the Hajós construction does not produce a unique graph given any two input graphs. The output depends on our choice of edges and our choice of which endpoint of each edge we choose to merge, unless the graphs are completely symmetric as in our previous example. To demonstrate this, let's apply the Hajós construction with edge CB and 4, 1. Feel free to pause the video and find the result yourself. Identify vertices C and 4. Delete the two original edges. Link vertex B and vertex 1. This is the result. It is indeed different than our previous result. Next, let's take a look at why the Hajós construction is important. First, we'll need the concept of a critical graph. A k-critical graph is a graph that requires k colors to properly color, while all of its proper subgraphs require less than k colors to properly color. Essentially, removing any vertex or any edge from such a graph reduces its chromatic number. Complete graphs on k vertices are one example of a k-critical graph. Next, we'll need the concept of a k-constructible graph. To begin, the complete graph on k vertices is defined to be k-constructible. Then, we are given several rules for finding the other k-constructible graphs. The first is this. If we have two k-constructible graphs, G and H, not necessarily distinct graphs, then the graphs formed by applying the Hajós construction to G and H are also k-constructible. Also, if we have some k-constructible graph G, the graph formed by taking any two non-adjacent vertices in G and merging them into a single vertex is also a k-constructible graph. These are the rules by which we find k-constructible graphs. For example, suppose we had two complete graphs on three vertices. By definition, they are three constructible. Then by applying the Hajós construction, we get another three constructible graph. And by merging non-adjacent vertices C and 2, we find yet another 3-constructible graph. To build any k-constructible graph, you always start with 2 complete graphs on k vertices, and then apply the allowed operations until you get your k-constructible graph. This is a 4-constructible graph. For fun, I'd like to quickly show you how this was constructed using our allowed operations. All right, here's something interesting. Every k-constructible graph requires at least k colors to properly color. The complete graphs on k vertices obviously require k colors to properly color. So why is it that the other k-constructible graphs that we get by combining non-adjacent vertices or applying the Hajós construction also require at least k colors? This is because identifying non-adjacent vertices does not decrease chromatic number. And the Hajós construction does not decrease chromatic number when both graphs have the same chromatic number. First, let's look at the first operation, that of merging non-adjacent vertices. Suppose we had some graph G with chromatic number K, with non-adjacent vertices U and V, and that the graph G prime, formed by merging vertices U and V into a single vertex Z, had chromatic number at most K minus 1. Then this implies that there's a proper coloring of the original graph with at most K minus 1 colors, a contradiction. To demonstrate, assume that we properly colored G prime with K minus 1 colors. Define a coloring function, f, which takes as its input vertices of G prime and outputs the color used in our proper k minus 1 coloring of G prime. Next, notice that the graph formed by deleting vertex Z from G prime is the same graph as formed by deleting vertices U and V from G. Also, since G prime was originally properly colored by function f, the remaining graph is still properly colored by f. Therefore, if we return to our original graph G, we could apply the coloring function f to all of the vertices in G except for vertices U and V, and get a proper coloring of that subgraph of G, with at most k minus 1 colors. Next, consider what happens when we add back in vertex Z to G prime. F of Z must be a color distinct from the color used on any neighbor of Z. And by definition of combining vertices, F of Z must be a color distinct from the color used on any neighbor of vertex U, and distinct from the color used on any neighbor of vertex V. Now, keeping this in mind, let's return our attention to the original graph G. We have already applied function f to properly color the subgraph excluding vertices U and V. Yet, by the fact that U and V were not adjacent in G, we can give them both the color f of Z used on vertex Z and G prime. What we have just done is defined a new coloring function, C. C of x equals f of x for all x not equal to vertex U or vertex V, and C of x equals f of z when x equals vertex U or x equals vertex V. Since the codomain of this function is the same set as the codomain of function f, and since function f's codomain was a set of k minus 1 colors, then we have ourselves a k minus 1 coloring of graph G. But that contradicts our statement that G had chromatic number K. And so merging two non-adjacent vertices cannot decrease the chromatic number of the graph. Let's move on to why the Hajós construction does not decrease chromatic number when applied to graphs with the same chromatic number. First, suppose we have two graphs G and H, both with chromatic number K, and that we apply a K coloring to these graphs. Next, As part one of the Hajós construction, choose two edges and merge two of their endpoint vertices. We can keep a K coloring of this joined graph by ensuring that the color used on the two endpoints V and X in the original graph was the same, and then assigning that color to our merged vertex Z. Next, notice that neither of these subgraphs could be colored with fewer than K colors, because they are isomorphic to the original graphs G and H, which were both defined to have chromatic number K. So far, so good, as our graph still has chromatic number at least K. Now let's continue the Hajós construction. Delete the chosen edges, and connect the endpoints that were not merged. This resulting graph cannot have chromatic number less than K. Why? Well, suppose I give you some arbitrary graph of chromatic number K, colored with K colors, and then I tell you by removing an edge, AB, from this graph, it can be colored in K-1 colors. The only logical conclusion is that in the new graph, one of the endpoints of that edge, AB, was colored with the color used on the other endpoint of that edge. That is, in any K-1 coloring of this new graph, the two old endpoints A and B have to have the same color. Otherwise, if the two points remained of opposite color and you could still color the graph with K-1 colors, then by adding the edge back in, you obtain a K-1 proper coloring of the original graph. A contradiction, because the original graph had chromatic number K. Revisiting our Hajós construction, what we have is a graph comprised of two merged subgraphs with chromatic number K. We removed one edge from each subgraph, meaning at most we decreased the chromatic number by one in each subgraph. For reasons we just discussed, if we decrease the chromatic number by one in the subgraph G, vertex Z and W would have to have the same color in any K-1 coloring. And if we decrease the chromatic number by 1 in the subgraph H, then Z and Y would have to have the same color in any K-1 coloring. So that means if we decrease the chromatic number of both subgraphs by 1, which would be necessary in order to decrease the chromatic number of the entire graph, then all three of these vertices would have to have the same color in a proper coloring of the graph. But that's impossible because W and Y are adjacent. That means at least one of the two must be colored differently than the merged vertex in any proper coloring. Whichever one it is, the subgraph it belongs to cannot be properly colored with less than K colors, meaning the entire graph still has chromatic number at least K. Essentially, the reason the Hajós construction does not decrease chromatic number is that final step, linking the two former endpoints. And that is why K-constructible graphs cannot be properly colored with less than K colors. In summary, the methods of generating a K-constructible graph, starting from the complete graph on K vertices, do not decrease chromatic number. When we apply the Hajós construction to the complete graphs to form our first non-complete K-constructible graphs, we get a graph with chromatic number K. Then if we choose to apply the operation of merging non-adjacent vertices, we would be doing so to a graph with chromatic number K, meaning the resulting graph would also have chromatic number K. If instead we did the Hajós construction again, we would be operating only on graphs with chromatic number K. There's no way we can ever escape the grip of the chromatic number K after starting with the complete graphs on K vertices. As a concrete example, say we have two 3-constructible graphs, the complete graphs on 3 vertices. And then we apply the Hajós construction to get this 5 cycle. And then suppose we merge these two vertices. The resulting graph still has chromatic number 3, because at no point could we have decreased its chromatic number. Interestingly, the mathematician Hajós proved an even stronger result. A graph requires at least k colors to properly color, if and only if it contains a k-constructible graph as a subgraph. Now, the fact that if a graph contains a k-constructible subgraph, then it requires at least k colors is obvious because we just proved k-constructible graphs require at least k colors. But the reverse is not obvious. Let's look at an application of the result that all graphs with chromatic number at least k must contain a k-constructible subgraph. The application of this result is that every k-critical graph is a k-constructible graph. Recall that a graph is k-critical if it has chromatic number k, but if all of its proper subgraphs have chromatic number less than k. That is, the removal of any edge or vertex from the graph results in a decreased chromatic number. By our result, every graph with chromatic number k must contain a k-constructible subgraph. So if a k-critical graph G was not itself a k-constructible graph, we could find a k-constructible proper subgraph of G, and thus a proper subgraph of chromatic number at least k, meaning that G is not k-critical. However, it is not true that every k-constructible graph is k-critical. Here's one example of a k-constructible graph that isn't k-critical. That's it for this video. In future videos, we'll take a deeper look at the Hajós construction and look at a really neat graph product called the modular product of graphs. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment if you liked the video. Have a great day.